positive and negative feedback. My favorite thing is that I have a gift that I can tell when somebody's going to give me a negative or a positive bit of feedback, right? Because what happens is every negative message to me will start with the same salutation, which is eta clear. It's obvious. One dude sent me a message recently where he said, Aisha Takya. And I was like, hey? He's like, sorry, autocorrect. I meant eta clear. I got this one guy sent me a message which started with the standard greeting of eta clear. And I'm like, thank you so much for following protocol. We are a very conscientious HR department in this organization of myself. And he starts with a message by saying, hey Takya, tera comedy mujhe pasand hai. I'm like, twist. He's like, kai baar main hasta bhi hai. I'm like, me too. He's like, par abhi apne aap ko kabu mein rakh, nahi to tujhe uda dega. How do you take such a sharp left? How do you be like, I did a couple of jokes. Okay, I did a couple of jokes about India's Prime Minister Mohan Bhagwat. And I mean India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And I and I done similar jokes about India's previous Prime Minister Robert Vadra. And I mean Panmohan Singh. I done those jokes. The thing is that nowadays nobody wants to engage with anyone. Like you, if you see somebody having a slightly differing opinion or even having an opinion, you are like, this is a problem. So the immediate instinct is that you want to label the person, because once you label somebody, it means you don't need to engage with that person anymore. I have labeled you, I have identified you as XYZ, that means everything else, I don't need to converse with you. So this guy went on and standing, he's like, bhai, teri problem kya hai na? He's like, tu leftist hai. I'm like, I'm a leftist once a day. And that also never in public. I'm not Louis C.K. My hand is in my pocket out of coincidence. This is not. But we like to label, man. We like to label. The guy went on with his whole labels. He went on a whole list of labels. He just went after me for all these jokes that I'd done. He's like, you're a leftist, you're a liberal, you're a secular, you're a prostitute. I'm like, main press mein bhi nahi. He's like, you're urban Naxal. I'm like, what is this advanced level? He's like, you're Chinese communist, you're Putin ka pichwada. Then he called me the greatest thing I've ever been called in my entire life. He's like, you are Librandu. I'm like, what is Librandu? But what a great, like, I mean, like, it's such a great word, a Librandu. Like, it's like, I don't know what you guys do. It's like, hey, I'm a lawyer. I'm a chartered accountant. I'm like, I'm a Librandu. Like, it's such a great job. I don't like labels, man. I'm not a fan of labels. I don't even like people who get labeled as a bhakt. I don't like it. Just somebody says something positive about, like, anything positive about, like, tu bhakt hai. It's so lazy. It's basically you're saying that I don't want to engage with this person. I don't want to know anything about this person. You paint the entire person on the basis of one thing they said, right? Right? And also, you got to give points to right-wingers. They're creative about the insults. They take time. They're like, Librandu. And the other side, they're like, bhakt. I'm like, at least try. At least think of something beyond bhakt. Modi chur ka laddu. Like, at least try. Like, that makes no sense, but at least you're trying, right? No, I'm not saying that bhakts and librandus don't exist in the world. They do. But I'm saying that just because you say one thing or have an opinion about one thing which is about this side, doesn't mean you're that side, right? Just because you eat Mughlai paneer doesn't make you Akbar. I find all of it crazy. And a friend of mine was like, oh, what are you? Huh? What are you then? Huh? You don't like left, you don't like right, who do you? You're not leftist, you're not rightist, you're not centrist, you're not dentist, you're not existentialist, who do you? I'm like, I am undecided. How many people are undecided? How many people are like, you just see both sides and it's like watching a tennis match of propaganda. How many people are undecided? Are there any people undecided here? Yeah, a few people raising their hands. Yeah, it's a lot of us, right? And people make fun of us. They're like, you people should make up your mind, choose a side. I'm like, no, we are the reason elections exist. We are the expression of democracy because people have made up their mind and we are like, I'm going to stay. Impress karo chalo. Is saal kaun choose karenge malum nahi. I enjoyed, man. I didn't know how to deal with a lot of this this hate, right? So I do think it's people's initiative. It's the whole nature of social media to say whatever you want. And I don't know how to deal with it. And then I had the following conversation with the guy. Okay, the guy sent me a DM, direct message, on Facebook, and it started with the standard greeting of, thank you. So I replied to him saying, "Mat fod." And he replied back to me saying, "Okay." All they were waiting for was me to say no. I was like, "Nahi, mat fod." And I'm confused on this guy from a moral standpoint, right? Because on one end, he's a prospective murderer, but he believes in consent. He's like, "Aaj tera murder karega." Nahi, theek hai. Kisi aur ko dhoond lega. A murder? Kaun hai Librandu? And you got to give points for creativity, right? And the Librandu is liberal plus. Pandu. I don't know what you guys said. It's about the liberal king of Hastinapur. The Kauravs would have loved that joke. You know what I love about this joke is 9 people get it, the rest are like, Hastinapur ki de re. Hastinapur.